In today's video lesson, we're learning how to read an architectural scale so that you can start reading architectural blueprints and scale drawings. The scale that I have here and the drawings that I'm going to be using today are in the scale of feet and inches. So just be aware of that for those of you who are in different parts of the world. So if you look back at the ruler that we have here, you can see that there's a lot of numbers. So where I want you to start first is look at all the way down to the end of the scale, and you can see that there's two numbers, quarter and one, and on this side there's an eighth and a half. Now these are the scales that are on this ruler. There's actually 12 of them on this ruler. So how do you know which one of the 12 to use? Well, it's pretty simple because you just need to look at the scale that your drawing is drawn in. So you can see that the drawings themselves are actually drawn in quarter scale, meaning for every quarter inch, it equals 1 foot. So then if you look back at the ruler, it's very easy. We find the quarter scale, and you can see that's right here. So as we look at the quarter scale, you can see that there's a zero line. There's numbers on the bottom. There's also numbers on the top. Remember that each side of the scale here is working with two different scale systems. So on this side's quarter, and on this side is an eighth. So we're using quarter scale. The quarter numbers are on the bottom. So moving from zero over to 2, 4, 6, and so on, that's measured in feet. And then when you go to the right of the zero this way, this is a measurement in inches. And for the quarter inch scale, it's very easy because each line or mark represents 1 inch, and there's 12 of them adding up to 1 foot. Let's take a measurement then so you can see exactly what this looks like. So if I show you, we're taking a look at the kitchen plan, and you can see here we're going to verify this 13 feet 6 inches. It's a measurement from this outside wall to this inside wall of the kitchen. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to slide the ruler up, and I'm going to start my zero mark close to this edge line, and I'm just going to look down 2, 4, 6, 8, and I can see that I can get to 13 pretty easily. So what I do is I actually take and put the 13 mark here on the left side, and then I know that I am 13 feet all the way back to my zero, and then I can go ahead and count in inches. And so for this case, each one of these is 3, so 3, 6. So 13 foot 6 is the measurement. Let's move on to something a little bit more complicated, because the quarter scale, like I said before, is pretty simple. So let's slide down the ruler here and go ahead and take a look at the eighth inch scale. Now, first off, you can see that the eighth inch scale is different than the quarter scale, and you can see it in the inches. There's less marks than there was on the quarter scale. So same principles apply. In this case, we're using the top numbers because we're on the other side of the scale. So here we're starting at 0 and then going to 4, 8, 12, all the way down. But moving to the left, again, you can see that there's a lot less marks. But knowing that these are in inches still, and that these have to add up to 12, you can notice then that if we do the math, that each one of these marks is 2 inches and not 1 like the quarter inch scale. And that's really the hardest problem about reading an architectural scale, is just figuring out the inches. But if you take some time to look at these and knowing that these all have to add up to 12, you can pretty much figure them out with just a little bit of effort. Let's take a look at one more then, just to help you better understand the scale. Let's take a look at the 3 inch. Now this one's completely different. So as we take a look at this, you can see that the zero mark is right here. So we know going to the left is still feet. So there's 1 foot, 2 foot, 3 foot, and then we're on the other side of the scale, which is inch and a half. But we're looking at this side, which is a 3 inch. So then moving from the zero line over this way, we know that all of these marks have to add up in inches to 12 inches, equaling 1 foot. So now we can see that from here to here is 3 inches. So now we know that this is 1, 2, and 3. Okay, so now if we take a closer look, we know that this is 1 inch. We know that this mark here is a half, then quarter, and then eighths. So each one of these marks on the 3 inch scale is actually an eighth of an inch. And so you can see how this differs, and you have to sort of slow down with each scale to figure out what the inches are. But if you take your time, it's pretty simple to figure out. But let's take a look at seeing at how to read the 3 inch scale on the drawings. For that, we're going to turn the page to a section view here. This is an exterior wall section view. This is the interior part of the house. This is the exterior. It's a double stud wall house. So I want to know then the distance between this outside edge to the inside edge of the stud. Say I wanted to figure out what the sill plate width needed to be. So if I roll over here to my 3-inch scale mark, I can start with my 0, and I'm moving to the left. I'm going to see, is this bigger than a foot? And you can see that it is not. It is actually less than a foot. So I know then, and I need to move then and work off the inches scale. So starting at the 0 line, moving to the right, I'm measuring in inches. I'm on the exterior stud here, and I'm counting over 3, 6, 9, and I see 2 marks. I know each mark is an 1/8, so 2/8 or 1/4. So now I know that this exterior wall and what I need to purchase for the sill for this is 9 1/4 inches. You can see then how beneficial this tool is when you need to get numbers off a set of plans quickly. If any of this didn't make sense, or if you have some other questions, leave them below. Please don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel, and I'll see all your smiling faces next week.